welcome to this chapter. And from this chapter, we'll be start generating the white waters and the foam. So the meshing part is done. So you can see it's looking good. So the splashes are looking good, pretty good. And so after rendering, it will look more beautiful. And so you can see, so everything is nice. And now let's jump into the white waters. So just create a geonode. And name it as white waters. Let's give it a color, so I'll just need some gray color. Now let's jump over here. And so take object merge, and here if you, I'll remind you, so here we have given this particles and this is the mesh. So we'll take the particles to generate the white waters or the foam. So just take object merge and then just create white water source. And bring in the particles. So here in the object, we'll go to the, and this, so we need the particles. And you can see we have generated some foam or white waters kind of thing. So now let's dive into the white water source and let's see what is there. So here you can see, you can visualize the white water particles. So like the curvature is the red color, acceleration is the green, and vorticity is the blue. So wherever the vorticity of water is more, so the particles are in blue color. Wherever there is more acceleration, more velocity, so you can see the particles far away are having more acceleration, so it's in green color. And the curvature, so basically the curvature is like, you can see if there is a flat line and then there is a curve, so the particles are generated from that curve. So we'll keep white water scale to 0.75, or okay, it's less, 0.01. It will take a little time. This much more, so you can go to 0.02. So it's good. And keep the emission amount to 1. And now let's jump into the volumes. So here is the voxel size. So let's take the voxel to 0.015. So it will take some time. So you can see now we have got more details. So but for now let's keep it 0.1 itself. And then comes the vorticity. So vorticity, wherever the vorticity of liquid is more, so the particles are generated from that part. So there's a range and there is a ramp also to control the vorticity range. So I'll just keep this to 15, and that's pretty good. We have generated more particles. Or you can try some other values, like you can go. So as you increase this, so let's if you bring it to 10, so more particles. So 15 is a good value to start. Now let's go to the acceleration. So as I told, acceleration is the green color. So acceleration, let's try some 20. And 20 by 60 is good. The curvature. So that's, so this is the range of the curvature. So we can just tweak some little, so it is from the curve of the fluid, wherever the curve generates, so the particles will be generated from that curve. And the emission, so here we have, so now how much particles you want to emit, and the emission is, so let's make it somewhere 0.1, this is the depth, and speed range, leave it like this, and everything you can leave it like this, so this is fine. So you can just take out this. So to visualize this, we'll just create a volume visualization node. And plug here. So how you'll visualize the white water. So here you can see, if I go to this information tab, so you can see we have a attribute called as emit. So we'll just, in the density field, we'll give it as emit, and just visualization for now. I'll just close it, and you can see it's less, so you can increase the density scale, let's say 100. So now you can see, so these are the places where the white waters will be generated. And now let's bring the voxel size to 0.015. So now you can see it is more, the particles are more bumped up, it is looking good. And now just, so we can add a little more turbulence or something. So we'll just add attribute warp. So here you can take a turbulent noise. And we'll just normalize it. And I'll just plug into the position. So let's make it 1.5, this 1.5, and let's keep it 2. So a little bit turbulence is, you can add. So if you want, you can add, or you can leave it like this. So no problem. So for now just take a null. And we'll make it as white water source. Give them some, okay. Yeah. Make it so everything organized. And now we'll just cache this. So before this, put a file cache. And the caches, you can just make it white, water source. So I'll just type it as source.$f4.bgo.sc. Okay. source.$f4.bgo.sc. Yeah. And just save this. So just hit this save to disk. So it will take a little time. And in the next chapter, we'll be taking a look into the white water solver. So guys, thank you and see you in the next class.